Thank you very much, Deputy Chairman, sir.
Sir, I'm in agreement with my colleague Jairam Ramesh ji, and the resolution which has been introduced by Vaiko ji to the extent of 50%, as it's a 50-50% as stated by Jairam Ramesh ji, I'm in agreement with that. Sir, there is a misconception that the regional parties are narrow-minded and they don't have the national approach is a misconception and misnomer. Sir, regional parties or the states want only financial, absolute financial powers, economic power. In so far as other powers are concerned, whether it is internal security or defense or external affairs or other matters, state are not interested in grabbing the powers from the center. It is the strong center which is required in so far as those areas are concerned. Sir, therefore, as of today, in so far as financial powers are concerned, the center has got more powers, and it is only the states which are asking for more powers in so far as financial matters are concerned. Sir, as has been rightly pointed out, the devolution of funds has been increased from 32% to 42%, but at the cost of the centrally sponsored schemes. So that is not what the states do not, that is not what states do not want. In fact, states want more autonomy, more freedom, as I have rightly said, in so far as financial powers are concerned. Sir, we in fact require a strong center. Had the center not been strong, probably we are all aware that there was a law and order problem in Punjab and law and order problem in Kashmir, and had center not been strong, probably the Punjab would not have been part of India or Kashmir would not have been part of India. Therefore, it is very much essential for us to have a strong center in so far as those areas are concerned. Sir, in so far as education is concerned, one example I'll tell you. What is wrong in it? What is wrong in center establishing the educational institutions in the states? In fact, Jairam Ramesh ji has claimed that he is the author of the AP Reorganization Act, and the act says that there are so many educational center institutions have to be established in Andhra Pradesh, and they have been some of them have been established, and AIIMS also, All India Institute of Medical Sciences also are being established there.
He drafted the common minimum program.
Please.
So therefore, see, when some of the states have made an enactment allowing even private universities to be set up in the respective states, what is wrong in central government having a say in the educational institutions in the states when private universities are being allowed in the states? Sir, this is our point. Sir, like one submission to the honorable law minister sitting here. Sir, after all, what states want is, like there is a clarity on the separation of powers between the judiciary, executive and legislature, why don't you come out with the guidelines of the legislature as to defining the powers of the state and also the powers of the center? This is the suggestion what we can make in this regard, sir. In fact, why states require more financial powers, and if not unfettered freedom, some a significantly large freedom in so far as financial matters are concerned, is states have to take care of the social security of the various sections of the society, of its population, and it is the states which have got the direct contact with the people, be it the farmers, be it the taxi drivers, be it the fishermen, or all everyone in the state. Approach only the state government for their demands అండ్ దేర్ ఫోర్ ద స్టేట్స్ నీడ్ టు హ్యావ్ ద కెపాసిటీ టు ఫుల్ఫిల్ ది అంబిషన్స్ అండ్ నీడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ ఆఫ్ ది కంట్రీ. సో దేర్ ఫోర్ ద స్టేట్స్ ఆర్ మచ్ మోర్ states are much more accessible to the people rather than the center. That's why the state should have more financial power, sir. Sir, the data, even from the Department of Statistics and Program Implementation, show that the states have made good use of financial resources. It is not that center has got more financial discipline and states lack the financial discipline. States also have got the financial discipline. And further, sir, the data shows that poorer states have led to the surge in the social sector spending, not the central government. Sir, two more minutes. Sir, most of the facilities which people use in their daily life, be it the roads, electricity, water, education, health, etc., fall squarely under the state, but the methods of raising the funds are very limited to the states, leading to the big asymmetry between the powers and finances, sir. My last point, sir, India is a developing economy. India is a pluralistic society. I do agree with you. Sir, India is multi-ethnical, multicultural country. The resources are scarce. And the responsibility on the states is disproportionately high when compared to the center. So states demand more financial autonomy to pay due attention to their backward regions. Therefore, I request this honorable law minister to come out with the guidelines empowering, vesting the power, more powers with the states in so far as finances are concerned. Thank you very much.
Thank you.